Last time, we arrived at the Schrödinger equation for a harmonic oscillator that looks like this. This time, we take the first step to solving it, which is introducing dimensionless variables. Mathematically, this renders our upcoming calculations much simpler, and physically, this introduces a new scale. And this will make sense in a moment. Looking at dimensions, the brackets on the left have units of energy, since the insides represent the Hamiltonian. And on the right, we have the energy eigenvalue, which, of course, has units of energy. First, let's pull out a factor of h-bar times omega out of the brackets here. H-bar is in joules times seconds, and omega is 1 over seconds, so this has units of energy. This means inside the brackets, we do not have units anymore, because if we multiply h-bar omega times everything in brackets, it should yield energy again. Now we divide by h-bar omega and define our first dimensionless quantity, epsilon. Epsilon is a number without units. For instance, if epsilon were, say, 1, the energy eigenvalue would be 1 times our scale of h-bar omega. Next, let's define a dimensionless momentum operator, call it eta. We would like to write the Schrödinger equation in the following way, which means that eta has to equal the momentum operator divided by this square root. Sometimes people define a new quantity here, p sub 0, in order to write eta in a shorter way. Now in the same manner, let's switch to a dimensionless position operator, xi. Again, we want to write psi squared instead of prefactors and x squared, so xi is given by this square root times x. And again, we could write this in a shorter way using x sub 0. Keep in mind that not only does our equation look much simpler, it also brought along a scale for energy, momentum, and distance. For example, if we would like to know what a distance psi equal to 4 means, we use the definition of psi to see that this is equal to a distance x equals 4 times the square root of 2 times x0.